master cylinder reservoirs are going here, the lines have to go through the main body. I'm going to use a nice grommet, and it's quarter inch, basically, thickness. Regular grommet, you're never going to get it in there. You got to get the ones with the nice wide area. The hole's the right size for the quarter inch hose. So I mark the first one to drill through. step drill where to stop. So then determine the right size hole. Just feed it through. The lip over the inside and the outside. Mark it, so you know where to start. nice grommets for the reservoir hoses to go through to the masters. Everything's clear in that position, nothing they're going to interfere with. And all the inner brake lines are done. I think you notice in the factory, they had a hole here, and the body line comes right down right along the edge of there, and you have to notch the body, and it's getting it on and off can be, you have to come in kind of at an angle and down. I move it just a little bit up and out so that the body never hits it. And then on the inside here, we've got those pressure valves that put the different fittings on them. And you're to see the grommets that I just drilled in there. And we've got up top, got those two power connectors up there. That's for the brake light. The switch that's pressure activated. And all the routing of the inner brake lines. The one line with the blue valve there on top, that's going to the rear brakes. And that exits the chassis there and splits in two, running down each side of the body. And the other one stays internal and goes to the front brakes. And you can see it T up there and split to the left and the right. And then go through the chassis right there and over on the passenger side. So brake lines are secured, all torqued down. I put little blue marks on everything to make sure, you know, a couple months from now I know that I had tightened them down and they're all set.